Hello and welcome to the 11 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Heba Abdul Ghaffar. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, Chairman of Bahrain Olympic Committee and leader of the Royal Team, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, praised the great performance presented by the team's riders who achieved the second, third, fourth and fifth place in the Castle Sagrat in France. He hailed the achievement of the Royal Team, stressing its strength and the high experience of its riders in dealing with various conditions in the hope of reaching the team's aspired goals. His Highness pointed out that the positive results of the team, confirming that the riders are fully prepared to qualify for the World Endurance Championship. Rider Ra'ed Mahmoud was qualified for the World Endurance Championship after clinching the second place, while the rest of the riders required to qualify in the next races. His Highness Sheikh Nasser underlined the importance of the achievement, stressing that the Royal Team has introduced the young riders to participate in this race to qualify them for the World Endurance Championship. His Highness stressed that the results came according to the technical plan set by the team before the start of the race, which was based on the participation of young riders in such strong races. The race organizing committee honored the first place winner, Jean-Philippe from France, and from Bahrain, the second place winner, Ra'ed Mahmoud, third place winner, Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, fourth place winner, Sheikh Ibrahim bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, fifth place winner, Salman Isa, and sixth place winner, Houd Bouchiri.
Thank you.
representing His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, participated yesterday in the 7th extraordinary session for the Islamic Summit Conference regarding the grave developments in the state of Palestine held yesterday in Istanbul. The Minister of Foreign Affairs thanked President Recep Tayyip Erdogan for the invitation to hold this extraordinary conference to discuss the repercussions of the Israeli aggression against the Palestinian people in Gaza in order to deal with the loss of dozens of martyrs and thousands of wounded children, women and young unarmed civilians who were demonstrating peacefully on the anniversary of Nakba. In his address to the summit, the Minister of Foreign Affairs affirmed that the Palestinian issue necessitates constant coordination and consultation in order to overcome the current challenges related to our central cause, noting that our Palestinian brothers are being killed, marginalized, and disregarded according to all international laws, norms, and human rights principles. The minister pointed out that Israel continues to pursue its policies and practices in violation of international resolutions in complete disregard of the most basic rules of international law. The minister also stressed full solidarity with the Palestinians in their legitimate struggle for the establishment of an independent state on the borders of the 4th of June 1967 with East Jerusalem as its capital and the return of refugees on the basis of a two-state solution in accordance with the Arab Peace Initiative and the relevant resolutions of international legitimacy. The minister condemned all Israeli actions against the people of Jerusalem and the religious places, Islamic and Christian, especially Al-Aqsa Mosque, calling on international community to provide international protection for the Palestinian people and the establishment of an international commission of inquiry regarding the recent events in Gaza, as stated in the resolution adopted by the meeting of the Council of the Arab League held in Cairo on the 17th of May 2018. The Minister of Foreign Affairs reiterated the importance of adhering to the issue of refugees and the right of return and a just and comprehensive peace as stipulated in the resolutions of international legitimacy and the Arab Peace Initiative. The minister affirmed the support of the Kingdom of Bahrain for the role played by the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestine Refugees and the noble goals for which it was established. The 7th extraordinary session of the Islamic Summit Conference issued a statement condemning the criminal actions of Israeli forces against the Palestinian people in the occupied Palestinian territory, especially in the Gaza Strip, where unarmed Palestinian civilians exercise their legitimate right to protest against this inhumane and illegal occupation, holding Israel accountable for the atrocities it has committed in the occupied Palestinian territory, particularly for its attack on the 14th of May, which resulted in the deliberate killing of at least 60 civilians and the injury of approximately 2,700 others.